Why, Texas? Why? Why are so many of your stoplights turned sideways?
And that is a good question.
Not just the Lone Star State. What possesses a place to mount their stoplights horizontally? Let's find out. This is Gallup, New Mexico. 22,000 people hanging on to what's left of the old Route 66, though solidly connected to modern I-40. But even here, 400 miles to the west, the stoplights sure look to me like they're from Texas.
A viewer writes in asking, why do some states mount their stoplights like this, horizontally, red, yellow, green, instead of the normal vertical red, yellow, green that you see everywhere?
And what about colorblind people? Are horizontal stoplights breaking the rules?
So I talked to the states that do this to ask,
why do you do this? Texas, Florida, Nebraska, and here in New Mexico. All places where sideways stoplights are common. I figured the best way to find out was to just ask. And Nebraska and Florida wrote me back.
When I talked with the state of Florida, they tell me it all comes down to design challenges.
Each of which fall into one of these four categories. And to understand them, we first need to know, what are the engineering regulations?
You might be thinking, but a sideways stoplight's breaking the rules. You'd be wrong. The Manual on Uniform Traffic Control Devices is this magical book where somehow all 50 states got together to agree what road signs and pavement markings and stoplights should look like. And they agreed, up and down or side to side, either way is totally a-okay, as long as you follow one rule.
A driver has to be able to see the stoplight. If the signal head, that's the red, yellow, green part here, is closer than 40 feet away from the driver's eyes, well, from inside their car, they're probably not going to be able to see it. It's just too close. And if it's more than 180 feet away, a driver might think that stoplight belongs to a different intersection, if they can even see it at all. So the rules say the stoplight has to land between those two extremes. Like Goldilocks, just right. I really miss my golden locks. And facing straight ahead, a driver has a cone of vision, 20 degrees to the left and 20 degrees to the right. So we need to put the signal head inside that cone if we want a driver to see it without having to really turn their necks to the left or to the right. And finally, you don't want the stoplight too high up in the air where a driver won't see it. So the rules say no higher than 25 feet. But if you mount the signal head a little too close to the ground, well, you know, Mother Nature sort of enforces that one for you. So the vertical Goldilocks zone is at least 15 feet off the ground to clear the trucks, but no higher than 25 feet. Which brings us to our first design consideration. Sometimes you just don't get that much clearance.
So even though California never, ever, ever does horizontal stoplights, there's one right there.
This is the intersection of New York and Colton Avenues in Redlands, California, where the state decided to build an entire freeway interchange on top of it.
And the big bridge makes things a little bit squishy in here in terms of headroom.
With the overpass on top and big trucks passing underneath, there's just not enough room left for a signal head to be mounted up and down. Sure, engineers could have made the bridge taller, but bridges are unbelievably expensive. They're basically buildings you can drive a semi-truck on. Every inch shorter they can make this bridge saves millions of dollars.
Mounting those signal heads side to side let Caltrans get the red light down as low as they can so that a driver approaching the bridge can see what color the light is before they get here.
Guy seems bound and determined to keep interrupting me.
Off that Nissan.
He's doing a burnout with Nissan.
I've been finding that when I set up a camera on the side of the road, people start to do weird things to show off. And you may be a value-conscious person who likes to save some money, and you've already thought, well, it doesn't have to be just at a bridge. What about at a regular run-of-the-mill stoplight? That vertical pole that holds up the horizontal mast arm? A sideways stoplight can get by with a little bit shorter of a vertical pole to hold up its horizontal mast arm than its comparable vertically mounted brother. Not huge savings like a bridge, but metal isn't cheap. And you multiply that across thousands of stoplights in your state, and the savings start to add up. But it's not just for money's sake that you'll see sideways stoplights. Our second design consideration.
Sometimes there's a bridge where it's hard to see a vertical stoplight. The bridge may block the red light, but if you turn it sideways, you might be able to mount it lower and more people can see that stoplight.
An example, you're driving down the street, there's a skywalk for pedestrians on your side of the intersection, and that blocks your view of the signal heads on the far side of the intersection, especially the top one, the red one, the most important one. Just like before, we could make the bridge taller, or, to save millions of dollars, just turn the signal head sideways. The red and yellow light bulbs are now down just as low as the green one. Now it can peek underneath the bridge where you can see it better, which is exactly what the city of Gallup did right here along 2nd Street. Somebody crossing underneath Interstate 40 actually has a chance of seeing if the light is red, which it is. Okay, up next.
Florida normally hangs their stoplights from wires.
And back east, that's no surprise. Lots of states do this. What engineers officially call a span wire traffic signal head. And that's sort of a problem for America's number one state for hurricanes.
Non-stop coverage on Hurricane Andrew.
A windy day, be it 13 miles an hour or 130 miles an hour, wiggles the wire to death, just like your headphone cable in your pocket.
A stoplight dangling in a hurricane is going to get ripped off.
And what's worse, span wire stoplights are ugly. So Florida say they see no problem if local counties want to kick in a little extra money to buy a real stoplight on poles that actually looks good. And they're also okay if local engineers want to mount the stoplight vertically or horizontally. And side to side is especially common in those counties that get hurricanes. But before we talk about that, first, what if you can't see color? If you had red-green colorblindness, how confident would you feel in a split second to know what the heck these stoplights mean? They all look green to me. Let's go already! Well, thankfully, the manual has a rule for this.
The stoplight, red, yellow, green, has to go the same direction as how you read. Top to bottom, left to right. So no putting the red light on the right-hand side.
You always start at the top of the page and the left side of the page. So those are the places you'll find the red light. Unless you take a trip. Japan puts the green light on the left side and the red light on the right side. Totally backwards. But that's okay because Japanese reading is also the same as how we do it. Their stoplights are just backwards.
The National Weather Service in Omaha has issued a tornado warning until 6.
Nebraska talks about wind as being the reason why over 40 years ago, they started mounting the red, yellow, and green sideways.
And if the Cornhusker state thinks they have to deal with a strong breeze, Florida can be 50% worse. So it makes a lot of sense why coastal counties of Florida mount their signal heads horizontally. There's less stuff sticking out in the wind like a sail.
As the wind pushes on the signal head and the back plate that goes around it, it can make that pole want to bend. But if you put the signal head in the same direction as the pole, there's less frontal area for the wind to push on. It makes the stoplight more aerodynamic.
But even a really sleek traffic signal far away from hurricanes can start hopping up and down uncontrollably.
So as the stoplight gallops, it wants to go up and down. Gallop, that's funny, I'm in Gallup, New Mexico. It wants to go up and down.
And the wind won't let it stop. And eventually the stoplight gallops itself to death. But I'm gonna pause that topic right here because that's its own video.
So I kept digging, trying to find that magical reason why some states have sideways stoplights, and there really isn't one. It comes down to big wind, tall trucks, and short bridges. From Gallup, New Mexico, I'll see you next time.
Well, if this is your first time watching one of my videos, I just want to say welcome. And please consider subscribing to learn more about transportation engineering, all made possible without in-video sponsorships, thanks to 435 real-life road fans like you who make these videos possible.